What's up, y'all? It's Demogenine. It's time for another one. So, yeah, we're out here enjoying another day of Hyperspace Run. I hope you're having a great day out there. Beautiful day to ride. I got totally distracted. My ADD was in full swing. I don't know, I really have ADD, but we're just going to call it that for right now. Because I actually had a plan to do something for you guys today. And with the suggestion of Fatal J and my sis, I checked out this anime. Well, I shouldn't say anime, but it has an anime feel to it. But Invincible on Amazon Prime. Yes. I will say yes. Absolutely yes. This, I don't know what it is where we can have such a disconnect on what, comic book related animation and stuff like that is going on in regards to like what we see like with Marvel and DC, along with the comics and everything. Now, I know this is an adaptation from a comic, but I've never read the comic. I'm just learning about it. So I'm a total normie, right? So with that being said, this is the formula that you will have when it comes to these properties being translated to, obviously, motion form. But, you know, if it's coming from a book and it's being put either live action or animation or, you know what I mean? So your goal is to get more people involved in this. Obviously, you're going to have your more niche fans out there who basically gobble up everything, you know, from the jump. And then you have people like myself who didn't know anything about, but in my defense, I am a comic / superhero fan. So in that aspect, I am not a normie, but as far as like, grabbing your run of the mill people out there and say, oh, what's this? And they just pop it on. So when they told me about this, because on the Keepers of Force episode, watch that, check that out. I'm going to have a link in the description. They were like, yeah, it's kind of like The Boys. And I'm like, okay, I get you. So I'm like, the first episode, I'm like, okay, I'm not seeing it. I mean, yeah, I can see a little roughhousing, but okay, all right. And then Fatal's like, yo, make sure you watch to the end. Because if you don't watch to the end, you're going to miss important stuff. And oh boy. And that aspect, that's where we kind of got the whole Boys feel. Because I remember in The Boys, it was the way they ended it. I can't remember. I know it was that first episode. And I'm drawing a blank on his name. But the speedster runs through my man's girl, right? And 66, sir. It was like that. Like at the end of that first episode, it was like, yeah, we're gonna have a situation here. So here's now me being a normie with this particular franchise, I'm gonna put a little of my guessing hat on. Right? So I'm thinking the planet, because I know when you talk about this type of, godlike, superhero that's basically invincible, blah, 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 blah. Usually they try to, in the case of Superman, we get lucky because he's basically, your protagonist, right? But then you have somebody like Homelander who is, your antagonist. And then when you talk about something like Brightburn, right? Where you talk about like if somebody came and they were, sent to Earth to basically destroy Earth. And then you also have, on the anime side, somebody like Goku, right? Goku was actually sent to the Earth to destroy it, but he bumped his head and then he ended up becoming his greatest protector. But that's besides the point. So my point I'm going to say is, to me, I think the story that he tells his son about his people from Valorian, I think it is, that they are, this technological, peaceful race, people don't fly, and then they at a certain age, they get their planet jurisdiction, and they go in and protect that planet, right? I think that they are not technologically advanced, and they are pretty much, a very warlike place, kind of like the Saiyans. And unlike the Saiyans, they instead of being sent as children, they get sent once they are, capable of basically destroying people to another planet and then populating them, right? Because to me, I'm trying to think, what was the reason of him getting rid of the Guardians of the Earth, right? you know what I mean. the superhero team, and what was the point of him doing that out of the blue? And I think what it was is that once his son was of age, now they have to basically do like the lion and cub thing, and then see who's going to take the planet, and then whatever, blah blah blah. Because when you see, I know I'm fast forward a little bit, but when you get into the episode when his dad wakes up, Omni-Man, when he wakes up and he goes against the alien invasion, he basically destroys their planet. He says, "You don't understand, Earth isn't yours to conquer." And to me, that's like, So again, me being a normie, I'm like, I'm trying to put 2 and 5 together to come up with 56. So yeah, I think that's what it is. I think he's sent there to basically take over the planet. And then obviously now that his son is of age, he doesn't need the other heroes around, right? But then there's that other catch 22 with Robot. And I'm like, ooh, is Robot part of his team? Because it seems like, you know, when they seen, when Omni-Man was sitting there watching to do the recruiting for the new Guardians of the Earth, he was up there saying pathetic, like he's up in the shadows. Like, so I'm like, what's the connection there? But then we also see Robot letting people out of jail, right? And I'm like, So it is definitely very interesting, this cartoon, right? I keep about to call it anime. I mean, it really is technically, like, to me, it has more of an anime feel than your Western animation does, you know. I mean, because it's just hitting all of those points that an anime would do, you know, the gore, like the different take on a hero. It's almost like a hardcore version of My Hero Academia, right? Even though Invincible technically is a mutant. I mean, he actually gets his thing. I mean, he wouldn't be like that, yeah. So in My Hero Academia, everybody technically is mutants. And in this one, I guess you could say they're mutants too, because it's not like they're saying these people are, laboratory based. It seems I haven't seen that part yet. Like I said, me being a normie of this particular franchise, I'm not 100% sure on how their powers are manifesting in such a wide variety of, you know, people, you know what I mean? So, but yeah, now, obviously, you're going to have, like, the teenage stuff that goes on there, which is pretty dope. I mean, look, I get that you, being that you're in high school, you're going to have high school stuff. So, but with this turn of it, it kind of, like, it's weird because, like, Mark is basically caught in a love triangle for the most part, like a beginning one, because he has the first girl that he was trying to protect that he's ended up kind of hooking up with, then the girl Adam Eve, where you felt the connection beginning to blossom, and then obviously Adam Eve's boyfriend is a douche smashing out a bunch of girls, a bunch of the same girls, which is crazy. I don't know how that would work. Maybe for science, we need to find that out. I don't know. Let me stop. Oh, boy. But, yeah, so I'm really enjoying this. And I'm happy that they definitely pushed me towards watching this, because I'm like, now I'm basically hooking. I'm unfortunately with this one, I think this is only going to be like 6 episodes or something like that. And I think we only got 3 already. I mean, listen, I get that. You know, animation and, you know, filming things isn't the, you know, easiest thing to do. But, I mean, animation technically is a lot easier than doing films, obviously. Like, Winter Soldier's only 6 episodes. WandaVision was, 9 episodes. Like, it's like, they know people are home, right? you know people are home. You know, it's still a good portion of people who are stuck at home. And, you know, binging episodes is a thing. It's a thing, you know. I mean, so I don't know why you give us such a small sample and then be like, yeah, we're going to make you guys wait for next season. So I'm definitely looking forward to watching the rest of this series. And, yeah, I recommend it. I definitely recommend this anime/cartoon because that's what it is. But yeah, have you guys seen Invincible? I know I was a little bit all over the place because this is what happens when you kind of chain watch things in one shot. And yeah, my thoughts on it is a little jumbled. I don't do the notes thing. I can't. I'm not the type of person, like, if I don't absorb it all at once and just kind of, you know, spit it out naturally. Like, I might make cliff notes of things, but I don't just, like, write down everything, you know. Like, and when I say cliff notes things, we're talking about when I do my live streams. I'll do that. But when as far as doing like my regular recorded videos, your boy doesn't do that. So I know I was all over the place, so forgive me for that. But I did watch all three of them, like, all in one shot last night. So with that being said, what are your ideas on this? I mean, if you are one of the people who actually read the comic and everything, you probably know what's going to go ahead. And I kind of looked at one of the pictures I seen when I was looking for something for a thumbnail. I did see something like, yeah, I kind of get where this is going. So me, with my theory as far as, you know, the lion versus the cub and everything, I'm pretty sure that's what's going to happen. But have you guys seen Invincible? What do you feel about it? Do you like it? Do you not like it? Are you a normie or are you, you know, hardcore with this franchise? Let me know in the comments. Like, share, and subscribe. And of course, hit the notification bell so you can maybe to drop them. And remember, you can't be good at it. And ride safe out there. Peace. Manipulation, consolidation. I heard that the best bet is Monopoly.